Hello, everyone. Bonjour, tout le monde. I'm happy to be joined today by Minister Anand and Minister Carr, as well as Dr. Tam and Dr. New. Chaque année, quand on arrive à la longue fin de semaine de mai, on sait qu'il reste environ un mois avant le début officiel de l'été. Après un hiver et un printemps difficiles, on a tous très hâte à l'été. Cette année, la longue fin de semaine a été d'autant plus spéciale puisqu'elle a marqué un point tournant dans notre lutte contre la COVID-19. On vient de franchir le cap de plus de la moitié des Canadiens qui ont reçu au moins une dose de vaccin. More than half of Canadians have now received at least one dose of a COVID-19 vaccine. And that number is going to keep going up fast because millions more doses are coming. We now rank number 3 in the G20 on doses administered per capita. It's clear that working together as one big team Canada is paying off. To all of our healthcare staffs at hospitals, pharmacies, and vaccination centers, thank you for being part of this historic effort. You're doing a great job. Keep it up. We're all so deeply grateful. And to everyone who's now eligible to book a first dose, we're all counting on you. Make sure you get your shot when you can. If we all do our part, if we get vaccinated and continue following public health guidelines, we will have a much better summer and we will get through this crisis once and for all. There are lots of reasons to be hopeful, but that doesn't mean we can let our guard down yet. In a number of places, we're still facing a very serious third wave. Last Friday, I reached out to Premier Pallister about the extremely concerning situation in Manitoba. I also had a call with Mayor Brian Bowman of Winnipeg. I let them both know that the federal government is ready to do whatever it takes to keep Manitobans and all Canadians safe. As soon as a province asks for more assistance, we're there to help. That's why, in anticipation of Manitoba's official request for additional support to manage the situation, we're preparing to deploy federal health human resources. We're also looking at deploying medical staff through the Canadian Red Cross and sending support from the Canadian Armed Forces. In just a few moments, Minister Carr will speak more about additional support for Manitoba and what we're already doing in the province. Since the beginning of this crisis, our government has worked closely with all provinces and territories to make sure everyone is safe. And as long as this pandemic lasts, that's exactly what we're going to continue to do. Ce jeudi, on va tenir une autre rencontre de tous les premiers ministres des provinces et des territoires. D'abord, on va parler des mesures qu'on prend pour en finir avec cette troisième vague. En ce moment, ça doit être notre plus grande priorité. On va aussi parler des différents plans de réouverture. Les premiers ministres autour de la table auront l'occasion de partager leur expérience de ce qui fonctionne bien à travers le pays. À ce propos, pendant qu'on rouvre graduellement, c'est important de continuer de faire attention. Le nombre de nouveaux cas doit baisser le plus possible. On est tous heureux de voir les restrictions s'assouplir là où c'est sécuritaire de le faire, mais on doit rester responsable. Tout le monde doit continuer de faire sa part. Il faut continuer de respecter les consignes locales de santé publique. Et évidemment, il faut se faire vacciner quand c'est notre tour. Si on fait tout ça, ensemble, on va réussir à avoir un bien meilleur été. On va pouvoir voir nos amis sur des terrasses et éventuellement, on va traverser cette crise pour de bon. Aujourd'hui, je veux aussi prendre un instant pour souligner le premier anniversaire de la mort de George Floyd à Minneapolis, aux États-Unis. On se souvient tous d'avoir vu les horribles images de ce meurtre qui nous ont scandalisés et ont choqué le monde. Mr. Floyd's death was a tragedy, and it was a reminder that there are still too many people living with anti-black racism and injustice, including here in Canada. Last summer, Canadians, and especially young people, marched to demand change. From economic empowerment through the Black Entrepreneurship Program to proposing to remove ineffective mandatory minimums from the criminal code to historic investments in community organizations, our government is working with Black communities across the country to make sure nobody is left behind. We will continue to take real action to fight systemic racism and create more opportunities for Black Canadians and for everyone. Before I end, I'd like to say a few words about the arrest of the Belarusian journalist, Roman Protasevich, over the weekend. The behavior of the Belarus regime is outrageous, illegal, and completely unacceptable. This was a clear attack on democracy and on the freedom of the press. We condemn it and call for his immediate release. We also condemn this kind of dangerous interference in civil aviation. Canada has existing sanctions in place against Belarus and will be examining further options. We also strongly support action through all available international institutions, including the International Civil Aviation Organization, the Organization for Security and Cooperation in Europe, and NATO. We stand in solidarity with our partners in defending journalists all around the globe.